It seems like every time I think I've seen everything there is to see when it comes to shady business tactics in the gaming industry, somebody comes along and just blows what I thought I knew out of the water. Many of you have no doubt heard about a game called Star Citizen, an MMO space simulator that's become one of the most successfully crowdfunded games in history. Looking at its 2012 Kickstarter campaign alone will reveal that it managed to garner over $2 million in funding from backers, but on their official website, stats reveal that throughout the last 6 years, developer and publisher Cloud Imperium Games has managed to raise over $187 million from over 2 million players. And yet, despite the game having been in development since as far back as 2011, there are no signs that the game is anywhere near being completed. There is no word on when the single-player experience Squadron 42 will launch, having been repeatedly delayed since its originally intended 2014 release, and many of its promises have still gone unfulfilled as Cloud Imperium Games focuses on gouging on the wallets of its players rather than finishing the project that they advertised. Even in its alpha early access stage, the game's official store is already selling things like game packages, ships, upgrades, skins, and in-game currency at ludicrous prices. And you can even buy things like plots of in-game land as another added form of microtransactions if you'll believe it. $50 for 4x4 kilometers and $100 for 8x8 kilometers. But all that pales in comparison to what Star Citizen has recently implemented. The following information comes from Star Citizen's official store website, where they have recently added something called the Legacy pack. The description reads, quote, "Ahead of all others, this definitive armada is an equal match to the noble title of Legatus Navium, comprised of over 100 vessels from every noteworthy manufacturer of note. This perfect collection empowers any fleet commander to forge a lasting legacy, leading humanity towards a brighter future," unquote. That's basically a fancy way of saying that if you purchase this pack, you can buy your way towards obtaining almost everything in the game. You will obtain 117 ships, which is just about every ship in the game, as well as 163 items consisting of things like vessel add-ons, skins, tons of in-game credits, and all manner of extras and cosmetics. All that for just a one-time payment of $27,000! This isn't a joke, ladies and gentlemen. Star Citizen is allowing players to cheat their way to unlocking nearly all in-game items for the price of a new car or a year's worth of out-of-state college tuition. Oh, and here's the fun part. To even be able to access the webpage that will allow you to view or purchase the Legatus pack, you need to be a player with the concierge status, aka someone who has spent at least $1,000 in the game. So it's basically $1,000 for the privilege of spending $27,000 on an unlock everything cheat code. You cannot make this shit up. Let me remind you that this is a game that's quickly approaching $200 million raised in crowdfunding and is nowhere near being completed or delivering its ambitious promised features. And yet, the developers continue to push the envelope on ways to extract money from players. Here's the sad part. There will be a significant number of individuals, whales as they're commonly known, who can afford this crap and will put down the money for it. In turn, what the average player will spend hundreds, if not thousands of hours grinding for. The few rich players who can afford to spend $27,000 as if it were chump change will obtain all of it in a split second. It should be abundantly clear at this point that Star Citizen isn't a game about rewarding players for investing their time and energy into the game, it's about rewarding those who spend the most money. There is no even playing field. The rich or the financially irresponsible will immediately gain shortcuts towards the game's most lucrative items, goals, and achievements, while the average player will be forced to take the long way around. Now, in light of this news, website Polygon reached out to Cloud Imperium Games to inquire about the nature of this ludicrously priced package, and their response was that, get this, it was implemented in response to requests from a hardcore segment of the community. Head of Cloud Imperium Games, Eric Kieran Davis, had this to say, "It wasn't created in a vacuum. We were responding to what the community asked for. We have some passionate supporters that are not looking at Star Citizen as your typical game purchase or transaction, but rather a dream project they want to see happen. Yes, it was created in a vacuum, one that involves the developers and the 1% of Star Citizen's population who can't afford or are willing to spend $27,000 on what's essentially a cheat code. You literally just said that the package was created in consideration of only the most hardcore and passionate Star Citizen players. That's what a vacuum is. Most of the community isn't asking for shit like this. They don't want gameplay rewards to be based on how much money you spend rather than how much time and effort you put into playing. They just want you to take the hundreds of millions of dollars you've earned in crowdfunding and use that to actually ship a feature-complete game, the one that you promised 6 years ago. The thing about Star Citizen is that in theory, the game could be fantastic. Conceptually, this game could be a dream come true for fans of space simulators. But in practice and execution, it is clear that Cloud Imperium's priorities are way off kilter, corrupted by greed, constantly delaying the game and its features and drawing out its development to focus more on new ways to monetize players. They are drip-feeding us the game proper while flooding us with purchase options. And as it currently stands, Star Citizen is nothing short of a scam. It is clear to me that once the money started pouring in, the developers saw the lucrative opportunity to drag out their crowdfunding campaign, and that became the priority. Some will argue that they need money to make the game, and I get that, but we're talking about a project that's earned nearing $200 million in crowdfunding over the course of 6 long years. That's a lot of money over a long period of time, and all the developers have to show for it is a game that is in such early state of development that's so barren that you can barely call it a game. It's a tech demo at best. And given its incomplete nature, given how much it has already tested the patience of its backers, supporters, and players, Star Citizen of all games is in no place to be charging $1,000 for the privilege of purchasing a $27,000 cheat code. Frankly, the very notion of asking players $28,000 for the option to skip playing a significant portion of a game is ludicrous enough as it is. There is not a circumstance in the world that will ever justify this kind of pricing model. There is not a game in the world, no matter how good it is, that would ever make this okay. But this is all especially rich coming from a developer that's indefinitely delayed its project to exploit crowdfunding for financial gain, that's fucked over its consumers one too many times. It's also worth noting that prior to the Legatus pack, there was the Completionist pack that cost $15,000. So it's not as if this stuff is anything new, but it is worse than ever before. And I can almost guarantee you that at this pace, things will keep getting worse. I wouldn't be shocked to see Cloud Imperium take things a step further by eventually selling $40,000 or $50,000 packs when more new ships, add-ons, and cosmetics get added to the game. Yeah, I don't think there's much else to add. Stay as far away from this long con of a game as humanly possible, at least until the developers start showing some semblance of caring about achieving substantial progress and releasing the conceptually compelling game in some final form as promised. Unless you're insanely rich or just plain insane, it goes without saying that your $28,000 are much better spent elsewhere. And if you're just an average Joe who plans to spend a minimal amount of money, I say what's the point when the scales are so blatantly stacked against you? It seems pretty clear to me that the devs are only willing to seriously lend their ears to the top 1% of players who can't afford to spend tens of thousands of dollars. Anyway, with that, I would like to end this news update. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content and would like to help maintain this channel, consider supporting me on Patreon. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out!